Good evening. Or good morning. Good noon. Or good midnight. Whenever and wherever you're watching this. Welcome to the Sunday Poem. Today, it's a poem by Vachel Lindsey, an American poet from Springfield, Illinois, who is considered to be one of the founders of modern singing poetry. In singing poetry, verses are meant to be sung or chanted. And no worries, I won't sing. Probably. Vachel Lindsey was known as a very versatile and prolific poet. He wasn't solely a poet, though. With the art of the moving picture, he also published the first American study of film as an art form. He also saw himself as an advocate for African Americans, and while certainly he was well-meaning, his views were, to put it mildly, rather questionable. Though Lindsey's first attempts as a poet weren't successful, he eventually became rather popular when editor, scholar, literary critic, poet, and patron of the arts, Harriet Monroe, showcased his work alongside two other Illinois poets' works, Carl Sandburg's and Edgar Lee Masters, and Lindsey's name, now connected with those two other really famous poets, well, that helped him tremendously to gain popularity. According to Poetry Foundation, Vachel Lindsey helped to keep alive the appreciation of poetry as a spoken art. Lindsey's poetry performances attracted quite an audience, and he toured all over the U.S. Edgar Lee Masters praised Lindsey's work in an article about modern poetry in 1932, and Lindsey himself mentioned William Butler Yeats as someone who respected his work. There is also a rather famous story concerning a romantic connection between Lindsey and Sarah Teasdale, the first ever Pulitzer Prize winner for poetry, who considered him to be a genius. It's a rather tragic connection, though, that some say eventually led to Sarah's untimely death by taking her own life after Lindsey himself ended his by drinking a bottle of lye because of some personal and financial disasters in his life. Today's poem, The Spider and the Ghost of the Fly, immediately gripped me. It's one of those poems that I instantly knew what was going through the mind of the writer when he wrote it, and of course I don't know, and my personal interpretation is most likely completely off. When reading it over and over again, the poem offers so many more possibilities for interpretation than my own, and that is what is so fascinating about poetry for me, right? There is no right, there's no wrong. In the end, it's only about evoking something in us. And this poem certainly did evoke something. I'm curious what you say about it. And if you want to, let me know about your interpretation in the comments down below. Here is The Spider and the Ghost of the Fly by Vachel Lindsey. Once I loved a spider when I was born a fly, a velvet-footed spider with a gown of rainbow dye. She ate my wings and gloated. She bound me with a hair. She drove me to her parlor above her winding stair. to educate young spiders, she took me all apart. My ghost came back to haunt her. I saw her eat my heart. Once I loved a spider when I was born a fly, a velvet-footed spider with a gown of rainbow dye. She ate my wings and gloated. She bound me with a hair. She drove me to her parlor above a winding stair. Hugh, this is so wrong. I apologize. I'm sorry.